above average entrepreneur India Russell here, back with another thought-provoking video. And today I'm gonna have a little fun because I'm gonna talk about people. You know, you have to be in the people business. You have to love people. You have to know about people's wants and needs, because there's always a problem to solve when it comes to people. And if you don't know about people, how are you going to be able to put yourself in position to help people? So today I was going to talk about the four personality types. And all these personalities have a lot of similarities, but they also have certain little things that make them different. So today I was just going to touch base and share with you the four personalities. Now keep in mind that no matter the person, you fall into one of these categories, you have one of these personalities. Nothing is wrong with none of these personalities. They all are unique in their own way. So with that being said, let's jump right into it. The first personality would be the shark. Now the shark personality, they're very, very aggressive people. They love and are about their life, their lifestyles, their time freedom, their money freedom. They're definitely about their money. They don't play when it comes to their money. You're not gonna waste their time, and you're damn sure not gonna waste their money. They're very aggressive. They know what they want. They go after it and they get it. Nothing stops them. They have no obstacles, no fear. They just go head first. That's the pro about the shark. But the con about the shark is that sometimes they can be overly aggressive, and that can tend to push people away. A lot of people don't want to be around flashy or cocky people. And maybe that you're not flashy or cocky if you're a shark personality. Maybe you're just confident, but other people haven't mastered that confident part of life. So they don't know how to take it. So sometimes they feel like you're too aggressive, you're too cocky, and they tend to stay away. But that's okay, because you tend to attract the people that are like you. So that's okay. Now the next personality would be the whale. Now the whale is a great personality. They love people. They love helping people. They're always there to help. No matter what, they'll make time for you. They'll go out of their way for you. They just want to help, 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 help. A con with the whale can be that they can also be very persuasive. So other people may not know how to take that. They don't know if you're trying to help them for your gain and their loss. They don't know. They don't know if you're trying to set them up, if you have another agenda at hand. So sometimes, because you're overly wanting to help people, other people don't know how to take it, and that falls into the con of the whale. The next personality would be the urchin. And the urchin is knowledge seeking. They're master studiers. They want to know 100% of the information, no matter what it is. They want to know the facts. They want to know what they're talking about. They want to be able to hit people with the knowledge, hit people with the facts at all times and all different topics. They want to be very well-rounded. They want to be knowledgeable in all areas of life, because they like communicating with people and being able to have different communications, different topics, and be able to fit in and adapt when necessary. Now the con will be that sometimes they learn too much. Sometimes that's all they know. They just sit on all the information that they know that they have, but they don't do absolutely anything with it. They don't act upon it. They don't get any results. They just sometimes come off to other people as, you think you know it all. Oh, here's this person to come and lecture me about something. Go back into the days about how it used to be and tell you about how it applies to today. And sometimes that just also pushes people away. But again, these personalities have their uniqueness about them. So we all love these personalities, and it's fun to figure out which personality you fit into. Now, the last personality would be the dolphin. And the dolphin personality, like, they're just about having a blast, having fun. You know, they're the life of the party. They get it popping, they get it lit, or whatever the new term for turning up now. It's all changing all the time, but you get my drift. They're just life of the party people. They're gonna come make a good time for you in whatever environment that dolphin personality goes to. And a con with the dolphin would be sometimes this is all they accomplish, and sometimes this is all they accomplish in life. And that is a turnoff for people because they don't see you as a builder. They don't see you as getting serious about life. They don't see you as, you know, wanting to achieve grown-up goals, such as, you know, getting a house, getting a car, starting a family, starting a business, you know, becoming a businesswoman or a businessman. You know, sometimes they just feel like you are the life of the party, the class clown. You know, sometimes you're not able to change that perception because you have a lovable personality, a playable personality. You know, you might be the comedian of the family, and there's nothing wrong with that. There's absolutely nothing wrong with any of these personalities. Again, it might be fun to just figure out which personality you fall into. I would say I fall into a little bit of all of these personalities, you know, because I'm very well-rounded. I can be very aggressive. I can come off aggressive to other people. I love helping people, but I also can be persuasive. And, you know, I'm very knowledgeable. I love being well-rounded in knowledge and knowing the facts, you know, because I like to argue by facts over opinions because facts will always win. And then sometimes I know a little bit too much, but I don't use it to help me other than just knowing that I can say that I know this, I know that, and can have a conversation. And sometimes that is not beneficial on my part. And I definitely can be the life of the party. I definitely am a little bit of a comedian. I love having a good time. But I definitely have had a lot of years in my life that was all that I wanted to do, was party, you know, go out. And I just always wanted to have a good time, hang out with my friends, party, turn up. And, you know, life is not just always about that. Yes, you have to make time for that. You have to have a social life. You have to get, you know, personal. You have to make time for your friends, for your family, but you also always have to put yourself first and make time for you. And at some point in time in your life, you have to grow up and you have to really want to accomplish all that you can, because that's what we were put here for, to accomplish major goals. You know, everyone's talking about major key alerts. That's a major key, that you want to build a business, you want to own something, you want to have a franchise, you want to be connected to the right people that are flourishing in life, that are frequency on vibrating on high frequency concepts and vibes. You want to get around those type of people so that your environment changes, because we are not products of our environments. We are products of our expectations. So I hope you enjoyed the four personalities. If you want, feel free to let me know which personality type you fall into. And it's your girl, India Russell, Above Average Entrepreneur, leaving you with another thought-provoking video, vibrating on high-frequency concepts on this beautiful, sunny day. And I hope that you guys live life and always remember to build a life and not a resume.